We for sure live in interesting times, and in this video I want to show you the capabilities, in this case of OpenAI, to work with speech to text and text to speech. The OpenAI API offers the ability to convert an audio fragment of spoken text and convert it to text, and the opposite, the other way around, to send a fragment of text and to get from OpenAI an audio file that represents this text. So there is on one side at OpenAI the Whisper model that allows you to transcribe audio, and there is also a specific model to get an audio file out of text that you send to the API. And in TMS AI Studio, we have extended the TMS MCP Cloud AI class to take advantage of these capabilities via the transcribe method on one side, where you send either a file that contains the audio, or you send a buffer audio in memory, and you send that to the OpenAI API, and it returns via the event on transcribe audio the text as a piece of text. And the opposite, the other way around, you can also pass a string to the speak method, and it will return in the on speech audio, it will return a buffer, a memory buffer of the spoken text. And we have combined this, bundled this all together in an example that I want to present you here today in this video. And we created this demo with the latest Delphi 12.3, where we created a VCL application, and that application will have the following purpose. We can speak to our computer, we can speak the instruction to calculate a route from point A to point B, and have that route shown on a map. To show it on the map, we have used our FNC maps component. To calculate the road from A to B, we have used the FNC directions component. And we have used this with open layers, as this offers a free map on your screen. And we have used the OpenRoute direction services, which is also a free service. And here the central piece is our TMS MCP Cloud AI component, the component that is part of TMS AI Studio. Let's have a look at the code of this example, where we can see here the setup of the Cloud AI component, where we set the key for the OpenAI model that we will use, and we set the service to be used to the OpenAI service. A couple of logging, which is can be interesting to see what is happening when something goes wrong. And we have also retrieved a free OpenRoute service API key. It's a free key, and we have configured its service to OpenRoute service, and we have set the API key. And we have also set for our FNC maps the service to open layers. So what we are doing here with the initialization is we are setting up function calling from our LLM. We actually want that the LLM will use our FNC maps component, and it will use it for showing the direction from point A to B on our map. And therefore, we have added a tool to the Cloud AI component, and the tool is showRoute. The description is very important to make the LLM understand what this tool exactly will be doing. And so the description here is show the route between two places based on geo-coordinate points on the map. And therefore we need a number of parameters for this tool, and we have configured six parameters. There is the starting place, which is a string, and the name of the first place, and then we have the longitude and latitude coordinates of the starting place. And the same applies for the end of our route, so the name of the place and also the coordinates. And when the LLM wants to call that function, it will trigger our tool on execute event, and it will call here the show route method. And if we have a look at the show route method, what we see here is that it will parse or will get the parameters passed to this function call, the parameters that we have set up, the 6 parameters, and so it will capture here the start, the name of the start location, the geo-coordinates of the start location, and then also the name of the end location and geo-coordinates of that end calculation. And it will then use the text-to-speech capability that we added to the AI Studio, and it will use the speak method for that to give the instruction, I am calculating the route from place A to place B, and it will then invoke the OpenRoute direction service to calculate that direction and to show it on the map. If we have a look at the implementation of the show directions method, here you can see that the central piece is to get the directions from that OpenRoute directions service, and this anonymous method that is called when it the results were successfully retrieved. When that is the case, you can see here that it draws as a polyline on our map the directions retrieved from the service. And here it will also adapt the bounds of our map to where that polyline exactly is located. With this here, this zoom to bounds call. Let's have a look now at how we are going to capture and send the audio to the LLM. And also the opposite, how we will then instruct or send the instruction as text to the LLM and get the audio file to have it played by the machine. And that is happening here from this place where we are, this is a paint box where we are drawing a circle. Let's have a look at that code. Here we can see that to start recording the audio, we are calling the audio recorder library with the start recording call from the first microphone found attached to this machine. And when we press the stop button, it will stop the recording. It will retrieve as an MP3 stream the audio that was captured, and it will then send this stream to the LLM and will ask via the transcribe method to return the text for the audio captures. In terms of audio capturing, we are using the audio recorder class for that, and that is a class that can playback MP3 from file, from memory, but can also record from the default or a configured microphone and record that as and return it as a WAV file or also a stream WAV audio or also an MP3. That is actually a free class that is on our GitHub repository, so the audio recorder unit does all of that with the free LAME encoder for MP3 files. So feel free to grab that audio recorder class from this repository. It is just being used here in this example to capture the microphone and to play back the MP3 file retrieved from OpenAI to play back on our machine. So let's have a look at this demo in action. So here we have our application, and if we press the speak button, it will start capturing our audio and for sending that audio to OpenAI, have it converted to the text, and then also send that prompt, the text that it that we have spoken, send that prompt to OpenAI. It will be smart enough to do the function calling that we have set up to either as a first step calculate the directions, and then as a second step show these directions on the map. And so I'm going to click the speed button now, give my instruction, and then we'll see the result here on our screen. So let's start here. Show the directions on the map between Paris and Madrid. And now it was sent, this MP3 fragment was sent.
I am calculating the route from Paris to Madrid.
So it captured the audio as an MP3 stream. It sent that stream to OpenAI. OpenAI was smart enough to convert that to text, show the directions on the map between Paris and Madrid. This was the prompt that we then sent to OpenAI, and then again OpenAI was smart enough to do the proper function calling that we have set up, the function calling to as a first step ask OpenRoute direction services to calculate these directions, and then as a second step to retrieve this directions result and show it as a polyline on our map. So let's maybe do one more example. Show the directions on the map between Brussels and Rome. And let's see what happens. The text, it got it correct.
I am calculating the route from Brussels to Rome.
And the result is properly displayed on our map, and it also explained what it is actually doing by the text-to-speech API of OpenAI. And with that, yet many more possibilities are opened up for taking advantage of AI, adding extra capabilities to your applications thanks to AI. Think, for example, about speaking queries on data as simple text, speak it to your machine and have it executed on your machine. All these kinds of abilities open up for you, and thanks to the TMS AI Studio, where we have now added this capability of OpenAI to do speech to text and text to speech.